For most of your life, you've probably been taught that when you know or believe in something, you need to stand your ground, stay firm in your belief, and not allow dissent by other people. The problem with this conventional view of intelligence is that it produces many adverse effects, such as cognitive errors, biases, prejudices, and mental blind spots. Moreover, in team settings, it leads to poor decision-making and closed-mindedness that discourages teamwork and finding solutions. To avoid the problems and disadvantages of the conventional view of intelligence, you need to change your mindset. Adam Grant, the author of Think Again, suggests an alternative view of intelligence to improve our thinking, the rethinking approach. In this book, Grant teaches us how to make our beliefs open to change. Exposure to different ideas and accommodating them can greatly improve the way you find solutions to problems, make decisions, and interact with others. Here are the top 7 lessons from Adam Grant's Think Again. Lesson 1. Strive to be flexible. Despite many changes in the world since its creation, we humans have survived because of our ability to adapt. Likewise, we need our minds to be adaptable to change, to thrive in ever-changing environments. To be flexible, you need to practice rethinking as a skill. This means abandoning the idea that you have to be consistent with your beliefs, and instead allow yourself to doubt them, listen to other ideas, think hard about them, and accept the reality that facts can change. Grant also suggests that instead of viewing changing your beliefs as inconsistent or as a weakness, you should view it as a strong willingness and validation of your intellectual development. Lesson 2. Think like a scientist. In their essential pursuit of truth and discovery, scientists avoid biases. They do so by forming theories, researching, experimenting, abandoning old beliefs, and accepting the results, even if they were different from what they expected or argued to be true. The scientific thinking process enables knowledge to form and reform over time, eventually making up the facts we ground our arguments in. You should also develop this thinking process to re-examine your beliefs and knowledge, and allow change to benefit you and others. Lesson 3. Avoid overconfidence. Grant cited a survey to show that confidence in what you know can be either a dangerous or powerful tool. Too little can make you seem vulnerable to fraud or manipulation. Too much can make you ignorant and arrogant. Case in point, in the mentioned survey, people who believed they had better knowledge than others actually overestimated themselves, such that they failed to learn new things and modify their views. Grant suggests that you need to find the right type of confidence where you're modest and self-assured. Modesty and self-assurance can help you be aware of the flaws or gaps in your knowledge and thinking, but at the same time, they can help you overcome them. Lesson 4. Detach your identity from your beliefs. Too often, people stick to their beliefs despite overwhelming contradictions because they attach their beliefs to their identity. So when someone questions their beliefs, they take it as a personal attack on their identity or credibility, rather than on the belief itself. As a result, people are unwilling to change their views because their ego is hurt. According to Grant, we need to separate our identity from our beliefs to avoid identity crises resulting from a hurt ego. Moreover, instead of developing beliefs to shape your identity, you need to develop a system of values. Beliefs can be susceptible to mistakes or changes, but values are something people stay true to as more important determinants of their identity. Lesson 5. Embrace conflicts. One of the misconceptions of conflict is that it only brings problems. Therefore, avoiding it is the best solution. In reality, conflict is a double-edged sword. On the one hand, it can negatively affect your mindset or your relationship with people. But on the other hand, it can be constructive for creating solutions and emphasizing respect for the other party, thereby developing compassion and cooperation. Thus, instead of avoiding conflict, you have to be open to disagreements so you can reevaluate what's wrong and find ways to improve your argument, opinion, or solution. One way of doing this is to frame the issue on more than two sides, since non-binary issues suggest solutions that can commonly satisfy both parties. Lesson 6. Collaborate with people. In line with the lessons of thinking like a scientist and embracing conflict, Grant advised going beyond internal rethinking and trying interpersonal rethinking. It involves a collaborative approach where groups practice humility and curiosity to find common ground and solutions. Three ways to do this are developing common understanding, asking non-judgmental questions, and allowing others to make their own conclusions. These allow you to help and encourage others to rethink their arguments without overwhelming them with logic or reason. Interpersonal thinking also involves interaction and collaboration with your rivals. While exclusive groups affirm your beliefs, they may also discourage growth and open-mindedness, such that you already think alike with one another. It can also promote division from other groups, which may have more or better offers. Grant suggests exposure to your rival's ideas so that instead of competing with them, you can avoid hostility and develop solutions beneficial to different parties based on their perspectives. To achieve this, you should find a common identity with them, show empathy to a single member and then to the entire group, and dispel any arbitrary stereotypes you may have. Lesson 7. Practice motivational interviewing. Instead of closing yourself to other people's views, you should try motivational talking or motivational interviewing. Unlike persuading or advising, motivational interviewing is about guiding the other person to a beneficial conclusion or decision. When the other person responds to your motivational interviewing, you induce them to feel smart, as they come to a conclusion without you necessarily intervening or arguing with them. You can achieve motivational interviewing by following these three pillars: asking open-ended questions, practicing reflective listening, and encouraging change. In conclusion, change and conflict in ideas are inevitable in this fast-paced and constantly changing world. The best we can do is remain open-minded and be self-assured at the same time, because we're all just trying to survive. This will require us to constantly question what we know and interact with others who may have the solutions we're looking for. Thus, having a rethinking skill and mindset is necessary to improve our lifestyle. Thank you for listening. If you like the book summary and you want to see more in this category, please like and subscribe so I can create more. You can also get a free copy of the entire audiobook by clicking the link in the description. Until next time.